We want to evaluate the limit of ln of 1 divided by x minus 1. So you can actually do it straightforward. You can plug in the 1 and you will be successful. Okay, so you can do ln of 1 divided by 1 minus 1, which is equal to ln of 1 divided by 0, which is equal to ln of infinity, right? Because 1 over 0 is infinity. Ln of infinity is infinity, right? Because as x increases, ln of x increases as well, right? Indefinitely, right? So infinity. That's one way. Another way is to rewrite the ln using the properties of logarithms. So if you're taking the ln of the fraction, it's the same thing as having ln of the numerator and then subtract from that the ln of the denominator, like this, right? So then you can input the 1 again and you will still get the correct answer. You will get ln of 1 minus ln of 1 minus 1, which is equal to ln of 1 is 0 minus ln of 0, right? Ln of 0. So that's equal to 0, well, we don't have to write 0, the negative sign, negative, and ln of 0 is negative infinity, right? So negative 1 multiplies the negative infinity, that gives you positive infinity, right? It's the same answer as before. Okay, so that was the first example. The second example is going to be this. I'm going to write it a little bit higher, like here. Okay, the second example is going to be to find the limit as x approaches 0 from the right of ln of sine x raised to the power of 1 over x. Okay, so again you can try to input this directly. Let's see what you get. So you will have ln of 0, right, sine of 0 is 0, divided to the power of 1 over 0. Right, so what is that going to be? That is going to be ln of 0 to the power of infinity. Now, 0 to the infinity is not indeterminate. It's equal to 0, right? So that means ln of 0. Ln of 0 is negative infinity. There you go. Let's try the second method. The second method is to bring down 1 over x using the properties of logarithms. The power of the input of ln is going to come down, right? So 1 over x ln of sine x, right? So that's going to give us what? If we try to input the 0 for the x, we will get ln. So let's do 1 over x first. So 1 over x is 1 over 0 multiplied by ln of sine of 0, which is 0. 1 divided by 0 is infinity, multiplied by negative infinity, right? And negative infinity times infinity is still negative infinity. Great. The third final method is to substitute this function, ln of sine of x raised to the power of 1 over x, as y, right? So basically, have the y equal ln of sine of x raised to the power of 1 over x, like this, right? So in that case, well, first of all, notice that we can write this as 1 over x ln of sine x, right, to simplify it. So in that case, your e to the y, right, e raised to the power of y is going to be e raised to the power of 1 over x ln of sine x. And using the properties of exponents, you understand that you can write this as e to the ln of sine x, right, this whole thing raised to the power of 1 over x, right? Because if you do that, if you take the power of a power, the powers will multiply as they are in the previous step. Okay, so now let's find the limit of this. Let's find the limit. So we're gonna take the limit as x approaches 0 from the right of e of to the power of ln of sine of x to the power of 1 over x. Well, actually, this whole thing, I miswrote that. Yeah, it can get very complicated if you're not careful with what you're writing, right? So e ln of sine x, and this whole thing is raised to the power of 1 over x, right? So let's try to input the 0 and see what we get, right? Notice that well, first of all, what do you think is going on? What else is going on? Notice that this guy, before we input the 0, notice that e to the ln cancels out the ln and e, right? All you get is sine of x, right? So we get this. We get sine of x to the power of 1 over x. Sine of x to the power of 1 over x, right? That's what we get. Because e to the power of ln of sine x is basically the input sine x, right? E ln of something is equal to something. E ln of x is equal to x, right? So e to the power of ln of sine x is sine x, right? So sine x is raised to the power of 1 over x. Okay, so now let's input the 0 and let's see what we get. We're going to get sine of 0, which is 0, to the power of 1 over 0. And again, 0 to the power of infinity is not indeterminate. It's going to give you 0. So now, let's bring back... So we used e to the y. Now let's bring back the y, because the y was the original function, right? Ln of sine of x to the power of 1 over x. So now we're going to take the limit of the y as x approaches 0 from the right. Right? And notice that y is equal to ln of e to the y, right? Because if you take ln of e to the y, ln of e is 1, right? So what ln of e to the y, I will write a note here. Ln of e to the y is equal to y times ln e. Using the properties of logarithms, the y comes down, right? And y ln e is equal to 1, right? So y times 1 is equal to y. Right, so you have to take the ln of e to the y in order for it to become y. So we're going to go backwards. We're going to go instead from here to the first step, to the ln of e to the y. Right, so it's going to be limit as x approaches 0 from the right of ln e to the y. Now, since the limit, since the limit of the log is the log of the limit, right? That's a famous theorem. I'm not going to get into it now. You can take the ln outside, right? So you're going to take the ln of the limit itself, of the limit of e to the y, right? So, and now this is going to be clear, right? So ln of e to the y, the ln of the limit of the e to the y. What is the limit of e to the y? We just found it, right? It was this, right? Where was that limit? This was the limit e to the y, right? This part right here. This was it. E to the y, right? Because y was equal to ln of sine of x, we simplified it so that 1 over x came as the power outside the power of power. But in any case, this is e to the y, this whole thing. This whole thing is e to the y, just rewritten. Okay, so in any case, we found this limit e to the y, the limit of e to the y, this guy we found to be 0, right? So we just put ln of 0, right? Because the limit of e to the y, as we found, was 0, right? So ln of 0, guess what? It's negative infinity. So same answer using three different methods. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next video.